Many times in the interview, I came across a situation when an unknown problem was given to me. But even in those situations, I was able to crack those interviews. So in this video, I am going to tell you step-by-step approach how I generally solve any coding problem in the coding interview, which helped me to crack all my coding interviews. So sit back and relax and watch this video till the end so that you don't miss any crucial points. So let's begin this video without any further delay. The interview starts with the problem statement. Now there are two cases, either the problem statement will be in front of you in the text editor or the interviewer is telling you the problem statement verbally. So in the first case, when the problem statement is in front of you, then there is no issue. But in the second case, when the interviewer is telling you the problem statement verbally, you make sure that you start writing the problem statement in the text editor so that there is no misinterpretation or you don't miss any crucial point. Okay, once the problem statement is in front of you, you have to speak it loud. By speaking it loud means you have to tell the interviewer what is given in the problem statement and what is your understanding from the problem statement. Now there are two benefits of doing this. First is, when you are reading the problem statement, the interviewer will tell you if you are going in the right or wrong direction or your understanding from the problem statement is correct or not. And the second benefit of doing this is, when we are speaking out loud, we can imagine things in a better way. So you will be able to understand that problem in a better way.
It is very important for you to ask the right questions to the interviewer. Generally, I ask these three questions to the interviewer before even thinking about the solution. The first question is, what type of inputs will be given to the program? The second question which I generally ask is, what are the time and the space constraints to solve this problem? The third question which I generally ask is, should I just discuss the approach or write the complete code? So what is the point of asking these questions to the interviewer? So the first question can help you to analyze what kind of data structure will be given to you as the input. And the second and the third question can help you to manage your time in the interview. Because if you already know what is the time and the space constraints where you have to reach, then you can manage your time accordingly. So if you already know upfront that you don't have to write the complete code and you have to just discuss the approach with the interviewer, then you can put more time on thinking about the solution of that problem instead of thinking that I have to write the code as well at the end of the interview. So once you are done with these questions, then you can move to thinking about the solution of the problem.
After reading the problem statement, the first thing which will come to your mind is, have I ever solved this question before? If yes, then you know that you can easily crack this round. But in the second case, when you don't know the solution to this problem, you have never solved this question before, even in those cases you can crack the interview with the help of the interviewer. We will cover both the scenarios. So if you already know the solution to this problem, it doesn't mean that you can directly tell him the optimal solution. You have to still start with the brute force solution, and slowly and steadily you have to move to the optimal solution. But make sure that if this is the first problem of your interview, then try to solve this question as soon as possible so that you can get more time for the second question. Because let's suppose in the worst case you don't know the solution to the second problem, so you will have more time to solve that second problem if you will be able to solve the first question in less time. Most of the people do this mistake. They tell the brute force solution and then they tell the optimal solution directly. It won't create that much impact. What you have to do is, you have to tell him the brute force solution and then you have to tell him what are the flaws in the brute force solution, why it is not the most optimal solution. Tell him what approach or data structure you can use which can lead it to the optimal solution. In this way, you will be able to create a really good impact in front of the interviewer because you told him how you led from brute force solution to the most optimal solution. If the interviewer has given the same problem to all the candidates and all were able to solve this question, the interviewer will select only that candidate which was able to elaborate his solution in the best possible manner. So make sure you tell him how you led from brute force to optimal solution. It will make the interviewer think that this guy has really some good problem solving skills and he has not crammed the solutions.
Now this was the best case, when you can lead your interview from brute force to optimal solution. But what in case when you don't know the solution to the problem? What to do in that scenario? So in those cases, you must come up with at least one solution, which could be the naive approach. Once you have the naive approach in front of you, you can start discussing the flaws of this naive approach with the interviewer. This discussion will definitely lead to somewhere. If you are getting stuck to one point, the interviewer will definitely give you some hint and you have to just catch that hint. In my interviews, sometimes I was able to lead to the optimal solution by just discussing with the interviewer the naive approach without even getting some hint from the interviewer. So it can really help you that speak out loud and treat the interviewer as your friend. If you won't tell your friend what is the problem where you are getting stuck, then how he can tell you the solution? So make sure you keep discussing with the interviewer whatever is coming to your mind. So this thing can really help you to crack any coding interview, even if you don't know the solution to the problem. Now, once you have the optimal solution with you, now the next thing which you can do is to write the code. Now, what things you have to keep in mind while writing the code? So make sure when you start writing the code, you keep discussing with the interviewer that why this particular thing you have included in your code. For an example, if you have included some for loop, tell him what is the purpose of this for loop, how it can lead you to your solution. So keep discussing with the interviewer that what is the purpose of each and every statement, so keep it interactive. Apart from discussion with the interviewer while writing the code, make sure you are using proper indentation in your code, you have well-formatted code, you are using meaningful variable names. So make sure you bring these changes in your daily practice, only then you will be able to imply them during the interview as well. First, try to dry run your code on some sample inputs. Only after then tell the interviewer that I am done with my code. Most probably the interviewer will run your code on some edge cases, so make sure you cover the edge cases as well. Now the last thing which the interviewer will ask you will be the time and the space complexity of your code. Make sure you are able to compute the time and the space complexity of your code. If possible, try to tell the interviewer how you computed this particular time and space complexity of your code. It will assure the interviewer that you have not crammed these problems and you are actually computed the time and space complexity in real time. It will again create a really good impact in front of the interviewer. This was the step-by-step approach how I generally solve any coding problem in the interview. There are few pointers which I want to tell you which you can keep in mind for your next coding interviews. So the first point is you should speak out loud. I am telling you through my personal experience, when I used to speak out loud, I was able to imagine things in a really good manner. Even I was able to solve those questions during the interview which I would have never been able to solve on my own. So if you are speaking out loud, there are two benefits. First, the interviewer will never let you go in a wrong direction. Second, it will help you to imagine the things in a better way. So guys, that's all about this video. If you are really liking my videos, then please hit the subscribe button and the bell icon to receive updates whenever I post a new video. And if you have any suggestions on what topic I should create my videos, then you can tell me in the comment section. I will definitely look after it. So that's all for this video guys. See you. Bye bye.